الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أعلموا عباد الله أن أحسن الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار My dear brothers and sisters, last week we talked about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being a shafi, the one who provides healing, the one who gives shifa subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is to the bodies. And we spoke briefly a little bit about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being a shafi to the hearts, the one who gives healing and helps these hearts recover and these broken souls, mend these broken souls and make them recover. Today, I want to speak to you about something that each and every one of us, we worry about frequently. It's something when it happens in our life, it brings us pain. That pain puts some awful feeling in the heart, make the heart so diseased and sick and ill. How can I find that healing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My dear brothers and sisters, it is so hard for the believer to sin. It is so hard for the believer to sin, for the Muslim, for the righteous, for a taqi, when they make a mistake, and that mistake is against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their creator, it is so hard on them to accept that. They stay up a day and night worrying about it. How can I heal my broken soul? How can I heal my broken heart? And we all bashar, we all human beings, we make mistakes. Even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Kullu ibn Adam khata." وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّئِينَ التَّوَابُونَ All children of Adam, they make mistakes. So he didn't worry about that. But what he said, صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْهِ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّئِينَ التَّوَابُونَ The best among all those who make mistakes are those who repent after they do so. So making the mistake is something given out of our nature as human beings. Obviously, it varies from one another. But still, a mistake is a mistake. And that's why we're human. We make these mistakes. But what makes it better for you is when you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with tawbah. And alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We have Rabbun Ghafoor Rahim. You have that Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who's oft forgiving, the one who's most merciful, the one who overlooks and he forgives all these sayyi'at. And alhamdulillah, he opened the door for tawbah, repentance. No matter what thing you do, the door is always open, day and night, any moment. You don't have to have any special occasion for it. On the spot, you could still seek that repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One hadith that was reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim. Subhanallah, it's an interesting hadith that how Allah azza wa jal opens the door for tawbah, for hope. Those broken souls, those broken hearts, when they commit that sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us hope that no matter what it is, He's willing to take you back and accept you. In hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu warda, which was reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Inna 'abdan asaba dhanban," that someone commits a sin. Like he's saying, anyone commits a sin. That's what it means. So one of those who commit sins, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Faqala Rabbi adhnabtu dhanban, faghfirli." So after committing that sin, the person became remorseful, regretful. He goes, "My Lord," admitting to the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. In one of those moments of dua, raising their hands, making that dua, or maybe at night, crying about what they've done, or maybe in their sujood, he says, "My Lord, I've sinned. Please forgive me." So the Prophet said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, "Alima abdi anna lahu rabban yaghfiru dhanba wa ya'khudhu bihi ghafartu li abdi." So the Prophet said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty will say, "My servant, my slave, she recognized that they had a Lord who forgives subhanahu wa ta'ala and he can punish." Like they know. And that's why they're coming for seeking, you know, forgiveness, looking for redemption. Because they knew Allah subhanahu will hold you accountable for it. And that's why we're seeking his forgiveness. So the Prophet says, "Qala ghafartu li abdi." I forgive my servant. ثم مكث ما شاء الله. The Prophet ﷺ said, then this person, he stays in time as long as possible without committing a sin. But then what happened? Again, maybe not the same sin, but something different. So he goes, قال ثم أصاب ذنبا. Then he committed a sin again. قال ربي أذنبت ذنبا فاغفر لي. My Lord, I've done it again. I made a mistake. Please forgive me. So the Prophet ﷺ says that again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty would say that again. عَلِمَ عَبْدِي. My servant knows and recognizes he has a Lord. She has a Lord who can take them accountable for this sin or forgive them. Therefore, I forgive him. I forgive her. ثُمَّ مَكَثَ اللَّهُ مَا شَاءَ. For the third time. Again. And then commits a sin. And then he comes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My Lord, إِنِّي أَذْنَبْتُ ذَنْبًا فَاغْفِرْ لِي. Please forgive me. And Allah said the same thing again. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, قَالَ غَفَرْتُ لِعَبْدِي. I've forgiven the sins of my servant. فَلْيَعْمَلْ مَا شَاءَ. Let him do whatever actually he does. Which means, as long as he or she always come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with repentance, Allah is always willing to forgive their sins. That doesn't mean to premeditate that sin or premeditate that tawbah, like saying, you know what, let me do it and then I know Allah ghafur rahim. That doesn't work, jama'ah. Our ulama, they say, if there's anything we learn from this hadith, is the value and the virtue of seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Saying, astaghfirullah. Ya Allah, forgive me. Few words, but they mean a lot. And we all need that. You know what's the true meaning of istighfar in the Arabic language? The istighfar comes from the word aghafara yaghfiru. And al-ghafar in the Arabic language has the meaning of concealment and covering. That's what it means. Because what do you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do for your sins? To be completely concealed and covered. And then to be erased after that. So al-ghufran, you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hide them. Never be exposed. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all, ya Rabbil Alameen. We all have faults. We all have mistakes. And if they come out, subhanAllah, will be very embarrassing in the dunya and the akhirah. And that's why we say in the dua, Allahumma astur awrati wa amin rawati. Ya Allah, ustur awrati. Ya Allah, conceal, cover my faults. Wa amin rawati. And give me peace and tranquility, because I always worry about them. And that's the nature of man. And the nature of this dunya, that we make these mistakes. So the Prophet ﷺ is giving us hope in this hadith, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always willing to forgive the sins. Al-istighfar is one way of reaching that. However, just seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is insufficient. Why so? Because when you ask Allah azza wa jalla, you say, astaghfirullah, 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 this is now you asking Allah to conceal that, to cover that and erase it. But you have to show commitment for this to happen. That is what is called tawbah, repentance. So seeking forgiveness, absolutely beautiful, is the dua that you always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from you. But in order for this to be effective, our ulama, they say, it needs to be done while you utter these words. The also the intention to quit that sin and do repentance for it, it's in the heart. If the heart doesn't match your tongue, it wouldn't work. Like some people, they do. They do something wrong and they go, astaghfirullah. Just so quickly. Why? Because they think that will erase it, inshallah ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, we're done. It doesn't work like this, jama'ah. It depends on the magnitude of the sin. And whenever we look at the sin, we always compare sin major and minor. But our ulama, they taught us something different. He goes, never ever look at the sin, how small the sin is or how major the sin is. Don't do that. Because if you always look at small and minor and major sin, you always consider minor sins to be okay to do. He says, لَا تَنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ صِغَرِ الْمَعْصِيَةِ. Don't you ever look at how little the sin was. وَلَكِنْ أُنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ عِظَمِ مَنْ عَصَيْتِ. But always look at how great the one you committed the sin against is, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you see the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jal, whatever you think of it to be minor becomes major. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us our sins, ya Rabbil Alameen. And protect us all, ya Rahman, ya Rahim. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ثم ما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, there's something we all know called addiction. People fall for it. Whether it's addiction by saying things that are bad, lying, backbiting, or looking at things on the internet, whatever that is, it's still considered a sin and requires tawbah from that sin. So how often should I, you know, how long could that be possible before it's completely unforgiven? Well, alhamdulillah, the Prophet ﷺ has asked, Ya Rasulullah, al-mar'u yudnibu dhanban, if someone commits a sin, like what happens? So the Prophet ﷺ says, قَالَ يُكْتَبُ عَلَيْهِ, will be written against them. قَالَ فَإِنِ اسْتَغْفَرْ, says, what if this person seeks forgiveness? قَالَ يُغْفَرُ لَهُ, Allah will forgive him, inshallah. Then the person said again, what if the person commits a sin again? قَالَ يُكْتَبُ عَلَيْهِ, will be written again. What if he seeks istighfar, will be erased. And he kept saying it, salawatullah wa salam alayhi. And then he said that as long as you seek forgiveness, Allah is willing to forgive. So no matter how often, however, the heart needs to be present when you try to quit and when you make that tawbah. So the israr in the Arabic language, which means consistency and insistence in committing a certain sin, doesn't count if the heart is not present while committing that sin, or if the heart is there when you utter the word of repentance. As long as your repentance is clear and true, you should be fine. The other thing which you need to understand, actually, as a matter of fact, Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala said in Sharh Sahih Muslim, قال لو تكرر الذنب مئة مرة بل ألف مرة, if the sin was repeated 100 times, he said no, even 1,000 times, وتاب في كل مرة, and you still bring tawbah and repentance after every time, قالت قبل توبته وسقرت ذنوبه, Allah will accept that tawbah if it's done right and drop these sins. وَلَوْ تَابَ عَنِ الْجَمِيعِ, and even if you make one single tawbah, like one moment, you reflect on your past and you ask Allah to forgive you all of this all at once. If it was done right, Allah will accept that. My dear brothers and sisters, I know that it pains a lot people who are, mashallah, good and righteous. That's hurt them the most. But here's the thing. Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, لَيْسَ مِنْ شَرْطِ الْمُتَّقِينَ وَنَحْوِهِمْ أَلَّا يَقْعَ مِنْهُمْ ذَنْبٍ. It's not a condition for a righteous person not to commit a sin. That's not a condition. وَلَا أَنْ يَكُونُوا مَعْصُومِينَ مِنْ الْخَطَأِ وَالذُّنُوبِ. And they're not supposed to be infallible, like they never commit any mistakes or sins. فَإِنْ هَذَا لَوْ كَانَ, because if this is the case, قَالَ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِي الْأُمَّةِ مُتَّقِينَ, there will be absolutely no righteous person in this world. If that will be the case. قَالَ بَلْ مَنْ تَابَ مِنْ ذُنُوبِهِ دَخَلَ فِي الْمُتَّقِينَ. The one who repents from his sins. Like sins are going to happen. But as long as you seek tawbah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will count among the righteous. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count us all among the righteous, ya Rabbil Alameen. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها مولاها. عباد الله, إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان يوم الدين. وأقم الصلاة.